Hi, I'm Rachel, and welcome to my home that we like to call our Happy Safe Farm. And we refer to it as Happy Safe Farm because we have a lot of critters here, and almost all of them come to us from rescues or have been rescued from just a variety of situations. I'm going to start by talking about my piggies, Willow and Walnut. Willow and Walnut came to us from an animal hoarding case in Brown County. It was not a good situation. There were a bunch of pigs just stacked on top of each other in pens. So Willow and Walnut and their siblings were shipped out of that terrible place. The people who were keeping them there were prosecuted. And the problem was they had 70 pigs who all needed homes right away or they were going to be put down. And so I think about 6 rescues across the nation all volunteered to take in the pigs. One of them was in northern Indiana at Conda Animal Rescue. And so that's where these girls were fostered at while they were waiting to be adopted. So that's where Willow and Walnut came from. They were littler when they came to us and pretty scared, but they warmed up to humans pretty fast. It's really funny because Willow here, she's the big bossy girl. She was very, very, very unsure of humans when we first got them. Did not want to be touched at all. And now she's actually the biggest baby. She is a sucker for a good belly rub. Come on, baby. Come on. Ah, there's that good plop. So pigs are a lot like dogs in the sense that they just love a good belly rub. If you have a good trusting relationship with a pig, they'll just plop right over for you. And pigs, they have about the intelligence of a 4-year-old human. And they love playing games. They love listening to music. We have a lullaby machine that plays music for them at night. And they're just super loving, super smart. They both know their names. They won't come to them, but they will look at you if you say their name. Not right now, because they're busy eating. Over here we got baby Walnut. She's the smaller girl. You'll notice that they have a lot of mud on them. That's not because pigs are dirty. They're actually really clean, but they don't sweat like humans do. And so they have to cool off in the mud. That's kind of like a sunscreen for them. And so it's always important if you have piggies, they always need to have a walla to cool off in and then also some fresh clean water to roll around in after that. If you decide that you'd like to have a pig, there are some things you should know. First of all, they're extremely intelligent and they are very good Houdinis. So you have to make sure you have a secure enclosure for them because they will get out. Second of all, you might look at these pigs and I'm a tall human adult and say, wow, these pigs are really big. These aren't mini pigs, but you would be wrong. Willow and Walnut are both fall into the mini pig category, which is a pig anywhere from 50 to 250 pounds. So if you get a pig and it's advertised as a mini pig, it's not gonna stay the size of a teacup. It's going to get about as big as these girls. So that is an issue. A lot of pigs currently need homes because breeders are allowed to advertise that they are mini pigs because farm animals are not currently regulated in the United States, so they can say anything they want. They could say that a pig could convert standard DVDs into Blu-ray and not get sued for it. If you're looking for a pig, I would suggest going on Petfinder. There are tons of piggies who need homes. Also, if you get an adult pig rather than a baby pig, you know exactly how large they're going to be. You know whether or not they want to be inside versus outside, and you also know how they get along with other animals, children, and have an idea of their personality. Another important thing is that pigs are social animals. They are pack animals, and so a pig will be happiest if they have at least one other friend. Sometimes you will see a pig who it'll say, oh, they prefer a single pig household. There you go. That way you can have one pig. But most of the time you always want to have them in pairs of twos or more, because otherwise you'll have experience a lot of behavioral issues because the piggies will be sad without a friend. So another important thing to think about is to make sure the zoning laws where you live allow you to have a pig that will exceed 50 pounds to 250 pounds. If you decide to have an outside pig, you do need to make sure that they have a good all-weather home, which means in the summer they'll have a nice breeze because they don't have another way to cool down. And then also in the winter, you have to make sure that you can keep them safe from the cold. They eat mini pig food that you can buy at Rural King, Tractor Supply Co. They also love fresh fruits and veggies. Their favorites are pumpkins and watermelons. Also, most pigs that you will find on Pet Finder or through an adoption agency will come to you altered, meaning they can no longer have babies. This is really important not only for their health, but then also just to stop the overpopulation issues with mini pigs currently happening in the country. So, we're going to take you behind the scenes, and by that I mean behind the chicken coop, to show you broody chickens in action. What does broody mean? When a hen is broody, she will sit on her clutch of eggs and keep them warm in hopes that one of the eggs might hatch a baby. We're not going to linger here too long because broody mamas do not want you anywhere near their eggs. They will get pretty upset because they don't want you to take them. Mr. Josh put these handy dandy flaps on the back of our coop. Let's see if there's a chicken in here. Nope, but there's a lot of eggs right there. Chickens typically lay about, yeah, 1 to 2 eggs a week. Yep. Now let's see what's behind door number two. Oh, hi, Claudia. There's Claudia. She's a pretty girl. She's sitting on a clutch of eggs. Gotta keep them warm and incubated. Now we're gonna go away and leave Claudia alone. All right, so here on Happy Safe Farm, we also have some chickens. You'll only see some of them here. Our chickens are free range, and so it's hard to get them all together at once unless you have a lot of food. So, our chickens, I will say some of them did not come from rescues. We do have some older chickens who came from Rural King. However, I would encourage you, if you're planning on getting chickens for your home for purposes of eggs, try to find them from like a smaller breeder, just because the chickens tend to have a lot better care and are less likely to come with some nasty health issues, sadly. A lot of our chickens that we currently have came to us through last year during shutdown. There were a lot of people who bought tons of chickens, and because, you know, there weren't eggs at the store, so they figured, oh, if I buy these chickens, then I won't have to have eggs from the store. I'll have eggs at home. If you buy chickens for the purpose of getting eggs from them, it takes about 6 to 8 weeks before they will start producing eggs. So anywhere from like 2 to 3 months, sometimes more. Caring for chickens, they're like pretty chill, honestly. What's most important is that you have food for them, water. In the winter, you have to make sure that they have heat lamps in their roost. They need to have elevated roosting areas. And you also need to make sure you have a way to keep their water from freezing during the winter. They are very good babies. They also love to roam around. Chickens are omnivores, meaning that they eat plants and animals. Typically, their diet consists of plants, scratch grains, and bugs. So if you ever see an egg carton that says the chickens were vegetarian fed, that's not very good. And if it says that they were vegetarian fed and they're free range, those things don't add up.
chickens love to be able to roam around. A common misconception about chickens is that they're not that smart, but they actually have the ability to remember patterns. They have pretty complex social structures. They rejoice with each other when they lay eggs. They have different tones that they use to communicate with each other. And they will even mourn if something tragic happens, if a chicken dies. They also will remember if, like, a predator tries to get into the coop, and they'll have that trauma with them. So they're very complex animals. And fun fact, they are actually the closest living relative to the Tyrannosaurus Rex. So they're doing pretty good for themselves. Yay, chickens! Alright, so here are some of our indoor critters here at Happy Safe Farm. This happy boy, his name is Eddie, and he is a pit bull mix. He's probably mixed with a Weimaraner, and he is the happiest boy you would ever hope to meet. He loves everybody. He's never met anybody he doesn't like, and he will gladly give you a hug if he sees you, but he's kind of big, so it scares people, so we're trying to teach him that hugs come later, after a hellos. Right here we have Stella Bear. She is the newest critter here at Happy Safe Farm, besides the chickens who we rescued during shutdown last year. So Stella and Eddie both came to us different ways. Since we're looking at Stella here, I'll tell you her story. We adopted Stella from Indianapolis Animal Care Control in February of 2020. That is actually the highest kill shelter in the state, and the majority of the large dogs there are all pit bull mixes. And so Stella, we know for sure, we did a breed test on her, and she is about 75% American Pit Bull Terrier. She's also got some German Shepherd, Bulldog, and Bull Mastiff going on. Stella, we don't think she came from a good home at all. When she first came here, she was very, very anxious. She would go into like anxiety fits that we'd have to calm her down from pretty often. She didn't know how to jump up on a couch or the bed, and she wasn't housebroken, so we think she was most likely kept outside before she lived with us. But Stella Bear has come to grow so trusting of us and so loving. She is one of the sweetest, most loyal dogs I have ever met. She is also incredibly smart. She's probably the smartest dog I've ever met. And sometimes that's a good thing, but most of the time it just leads to her being stubborn and getting into trouble. But she's a very, very, very good girl. I think anybody would agree. Eddie Boo came to us in October of 2019. We found him on Pet Finder. He came from a rescue up in Indianapolis called Helping Paws. Eddie, he's about 3 years old now. And so Eddie, his backstory is a little mysterious. He was purchased by his first mom when he was a puppy. And then he was either got out and was lost or stolen. And he was missing for about 7 months. And then when they found him and microchipped him and brought him back to his first mom, she said that she didn't want him anymore. I guess he just didn't fit into her life and how it had changed in those 7 months. But that's okay, because we got to find him at Helping Paws. And he is the sweetest boy you would ever hope to meet. He is a bundle of energy and love. But let me tell you, he is the best snuggler I have ever met. And I will say, if you're planning to add a doggy to your home, it's always great to look into adopting rather than shopping, because you can find the best doggies who need homes, and the shelters are currently overrun with dogs like Eddie and Stella, who are so, so, so good, and they just need someone to show them a little bit of love. Some great things about adopting from a shelter or a rescue rather than buying a puppy is you have an idea of the temperament of the dog, if they are good with cats, if they're good with kids,
whether they like to snooze or if they're like really high energy, want to walk all the time. And so you can help find a dog that really fits your lifestyle. Another great thing is that if you get an older dog, a lot of times they'll come to you potty trained. So that helps you skip a couple steps. I will say if you're planning on getting a dog, know that the initial cost, either adopting or buying a dog, is not even close to the bottom line you'll be paying. Eddie Boo here, he was a rescue, but he tore his ACL this year, and so we had to pay for surgery for him, which was not cheap at all, but there was no other option, and I would do it several times over because he is the goodest boy, and I would do anything for you, Eddie. I would do anything for you. Yeah. But yeah, adopting a dog is anywhere from an 8 to 12 year commitment on average. So make sure you have time to give all the love the pibbles need. Oh, I'm sorry, dogs need. I mean, if you want to get a pibble, that's cool. I'm in no way pushing a pit bull agenda, but they are the best dogs in the world. Right, Eddie? Also, an important thing to know about doggies is that it's a good thing to have a big place for them to run around that's fenced in, especially if they're bigger doggies like Eddie and Stella. Another important thing is that every dog has different exercise needs. If you get a high energy dog like Eddie and Stella, they are going to need to take many walkies throughout the week, and they also enjoy various games. Eddie is going to try, well, actually, he's working on a soccer scholarship. He's a very good boy, and he wants to make mom and dad proud by getting a soccer scholarship to a good school. But the thing is, he already makes mom and dad very proud. All right, Eddie. Are you ready? Show everybody your training. You got this. Ready? Go. Go, Eddie, go. This is Eddie's favorite toy, his soccer ball. It's actually called, I think, a virtually indestructible ball. You can buy them on Chewy and they come in a variety of colors. I think they're about $20, but they're virtually indestructible, so it's worth it. Buddy, come on. Buddy, you're having trouble with it. You can't just stand. You see that control? See, he's been a little out of practice. He was recovering from his surgery, but he is just going right back into it. Eddie loves his ball. We have four fish. One, two, three, four. We have two Oscars. Those are the little blue guys you see. And then these orange fish you see, they are blood orange parrot cichlids.
Cichlids.
Cichlids. They're fancy fish. Anyway, these critters were not rescued. They were purchased from a pet store that I will not mention the name because I do not want to advertise them. They are very good fish. They do fish things. These cichlids are actually a hybrid, so they do not occur naturally in the wild. But here's the thing about these fishies. So as you can see, they have this huge 55-gallon tank, and that is the minimum tank space you need for like this many fish of this size, because they need room to swim around. They need their tank regularly cleaned, and it's a big one. And they also need their different plants and rocks rearranged just to give them some variety and keep them happy. These guys are super smart too. Sometimes I'm convinced that they're like watching me and judging me for my fourth episode of Gossip Girl in a row, which they probably are. And they'll also eat little shrimp treaties out of your hands. It's really cute. But
in addition to just keeping up with the tank, keeping it clean and interesting for the fish, these guys, the cichlids, they live to be about 15 years old. So when you adopt a fish or purchase a fish, keep in mind their lifespans and can I commit to having this huge 55 gallon tank for 15 years? If you can, that's great. If you can't, maybe think about a guppy. But yep, fish.
Now right here, this is the rescue critter that I hold closest to my heart. And her name is Lady Elaine. And even though I love all my critters so much, I say she's closest to my heart because she is the first critter I ever rescued. I've had Lady for about 7 years now. And she is such a joy to my life. I adopted her mainly because it was my first time living away from home and I was very lonely and a little sad. And so I figured if I had somebody to take care of, that would make my life a little bit happier. And I was very much right. Lady Elaine, I found her at Southside Animal Shelter in Indianapolis. And she is the sweetest cat you will ever meet, as you can see. She just loves to be pet. She loves being held like a baby, given belly rubs. And she just brings me so much joy. I would say that if you decide you'd like to adopt a cat, they're probably, the most low maintenance critters to have besides the fish. Pretty much you just have to make sure they have food, clean water. Lady Elaine loves a nice flowing stream of water, so I bought her a fountain. Of course, they need a litter box that you have to refresh regularly. Hi, Mugen. This is Mugen. He is a rescue kitty, too. He's a very handsome boy, as you can see. Also, need to keep up with vet care and shots, just like any other critter. And another thing is, if you don't really want a dog who needs to go for walkies all the time, you can totally sit on the couch and exercise your cat with a laser pointer or a long piece of fleece. They're pretty chill. I will say that every cat differs in personality. Lady Elaine, as you can see, is just the sweetest ball of fluff. Some of them are a lot more troublesome. But the good news is, if you go to a shelter or check on Pet Finder, there are all sorts of personality types of kitties for you to meet. I will say, if you decide you would like to adopt a kitty, they come with these very sharp fingers. Lady Elaine is an angel and therefore does not scratch unless I'm trying to put her into a carrier. But they do like to scratch wooden things, cardboard things, wicker things. So if you have a cat, that's a side effect, and it's very important for them to keep their fingers, as those, they're literally their fingers. That's how they walk on their clay and their litter boxes, that's how they defend themselves, and so it's very important that kitties keep their claws. Some alternatives to them scratching up your furniture are to have a lot of scratching posts and games for them. Sometimes if you sprinkle some catnip on their scratching post, then they'll go for it if they haven't previously been using it. And there are other alternatives such as trimming their claws or even like putting caps on them, but really the easiest thing is just to have lots of scratchers for them. But yeah, you are an angel and a delight to my heart. Mwah. So one last critter who I'd like to talk about who sadly could not be with us this evening is our chicken Daisy. Daisy was one of the chickens who was brought to us during shutdown during 2020. Some people that we know bought too many chickens, didn't know what to do with them, and brought them here. Daisy was a very special chicken because he was purchased by accident. They were trying to buy egg chickens and Daisy was a broiler chicken, which means that instead of being bred for eggs, Daisy was bred for meat. And so Daisy was a lot bigger than the other chickens because broiler chickens are bred to get really big really fast, and they normally do not live past 3 months old because they're used for meat. So Daisy was a very lucky chicken. Shortly before Daisy came to us, we rescued two ducks who were being kept in an apartment in Indy. Please don't do that. If you live in an apartment, do not get farm birds. Get a cat. So the ducks came to us very malnourished, and one of them had had a slip tendon that was not treated in time, so he did not live past a week. He did get to spend his last few days doing duck things in a pond, very happy, so that is good. But the problem was, we then had another duck who was bonded to that duck, and ducks are very social, so we didn't want the duck that we called Duck Duck to get depressed or sad without his friend. However, Duck Duck and Daisy bonded almost instantly, and they went everywhere together. They would wander our yard, they would wander the neighbor's yard, just talking to each other, acting like they were best friends, even though they were two completely different species. It was really beautiful and really sweet. Sadly, Daisy passed away in June, but Daisy lived to be about a year and a half old, which is so much longer than any other chicken of that breed tends to live. So he lived a good, happy, safe life, and I wish he could be with us today. I'm so glad you came to see our happy, safe critters here at Happy Safe Farm. The critters bring me so much joy, and learning more about them and developing relationships with them is so rewarding and wonderful. If you have any questions about the critters, about any of the rescues that I mentioned, anything that I missed, feel free to drop them in the comments. I will be looking and am ready to answer. And I guess as a final note, if you're thinking about adding a critter to your life, I strongly to encourage you to adopt, not shop. There are so many wonderful critters out there just looking for forever homes who would really appreciate your love and care. Anyway, thanks for stopping by. I hope you have a happy, safe day.